And right into the next lightning talk, we have Nikolai Abilov.
Abilov.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. No problem. So yeah, I'm going to talk today about Selenium-based automation for Windows and Windows Phone, and I hope somebody saw a Windows Phone actual device. Yeah. So, I'm a software development engineer at TuGIS. It's a Russian-based local search company. And as I said, I'm going to talk about Selenium-based automation for Windows and Windows Phone. And I'll start with why even bother, why Selenium-based automation? Why don't we use some custom API? So basically, Selenium exists for more than 10 years, and it became a standard de facto for web automation. And there is a lot of documentation, a big community, and a lot of common problems has been already solved in this Selenium infrastructure, basically. And also, Selenium uses this very nice architecture where it's basically a client-server architecture. So your tests are just an HTTP client, which sends a command according to the web driver specification to the server, and then the server actually translates this command into a concrete automation to drive a system under a test. And your system under a test can be basically any browser, any mobile, or even if you want a coffee machine or something like that. So this allows you to write your tests once and then to execute them many times on different platforms, ideally. In reality, it doesn't work like that, but yeah. So from the point of the user from who writes tests using the Selenium-based tools, he basically has a lot of common problems already solved, and he does not have to invest more time to studying new API and stuff like that. So it saves a lot of time. And from the point of developer of these tools, you basically have everything on the left already written, so you don't have to provide any client API for your users and stuff like that. You just need to fill in this magic part on the right of the picture. And the web driver spec itself is very simple. It's basically just an HTTP request, which can have a JSON body. And response is also just a JSON body, so it's very easy to implement. And together, there is, besides Selenium, there is also tools like Appium or Selendroid. And together, this family of Selenium tools covers almost every major platform, about, except for Windows, actually, until very recently. So like maybe in the last release of Appium, there was added support for Windows Desktop, which was made possible because Microsoft released a WinAmp driver, which is actually a closed source and it's in beta right now, but you can go to GitHub and download binaries and try it out. But I'm going to talk about the WinAmp project. So WinAmp project is basically an open source family of projects for Windows and Windows Phone automation. And I'll start with Windows Phone automation because it was the first project we wrote back in 2013. So we needed some tool to automate Windows Phone, which was quite popular in Russia. And we had actually, there were no tools for automation for Windows Phone, and even there were no tools provided by Microsoft, which was kind of strange. So yeah, we wrote a project which is called WinAmp Mobile. You can find it on GitHub. It's completely open source. We have like documentation and samples and stuff like that. And what it does basically is a web driver implementation which can drive automation of native applications on Windows Phone. It actually lets you run your tests on emulators. It does not work on devices, but you can hack it around and actually run on devices, but with some limitations. We also are working on a support for hybrid applications testing. And because it's Selenium-based, you can easily plug it into your existing infrastructure. You can use it with Selenium Grid to run tests in parallel and stuff like that. And there is only one catch, but I'll show it you here. So we have this architecture, which is similar to Selenium. We have your tests, and we have a driver. And when you send a command to the driver, this command converts into one set of APIs. So we use Microsoft APIs to manage virtual machines, which are basically emulators. to simulate user input, to install your application, stuff like that. But to interrogate UI and to interact with UI, we had to embed a test server inside the application under test. So because of heavy sandboxing on Windows Phone, you actually have to add a special automation server right inside your application. And this server will be able to handle commands like finding elements and getting their text value and stuff like that. So how does it work? It's very easy. Basically, the steps are similar for Selenium or IPM, except for the first one. So you have to embed a test server, as I said. And this is accomplished by adding a single code of line and installing a package. So it's very easy. And from then, you just write your tests like any regular Selenium test. So there is no difference, basically, from web tests, except for capabilities. So we have some specific capabilities which let you install application and install files into this application or debug your application. And in your tests, you can use standard commands like finding element by ID, by class name, by name, and etc. Also, you can use IPM bindings, which are basically just extension of Selenium bindings. And this lets you close application, launch application, and upload and download files from and to the application. And also, it lets you switch between contexts. So if your app has like a web view for authentication, you can switch to this web view, use just regular Selenium to automate this web view, and then switch back to the native context. But we haven't released it yet, but you can build it from sources and try it out right now. And also because we have this automation server right inside your application, we are able to do some cool stuff, like we can call any static method in your application, basically, or set any value of public property in UI. So this can help you with testability of applications. So for example, if you have like a map view, you can set coordinates of this map view directly, very precisely. You don't have to use like a touch gesture to swipe it, or you don't have to write a custom test API. So you can just do it from Selenium test. And yeah, then you just run your driver and you run your test like usual. And I have a demo. So if we can switch and turn on this video. So it's just one of our test cases. So we install application, we upload map and all the data into application, and then just try to build a road. So basically, it's a navigation stuff. So it does support everything like touch gestures, like swiping and stuff like that. So yeah. Can we switch back to the slides, please? No, like next slide, please. Oh, OK. Yeah. Technical difficulties. OK, thanks. So yeah, we have one more project. So when Windows Phone 8.1 was released, Microsoft actually released their own automation tool. It is called Coded UI. So we naturally decided to try it out. And we wanted just to swap out our Vimeo mobile. So we wrote a Selenium wrapper so we can just replace one driver with another and keep our tests. And it's also open source. You can find it on GitHub. It has basically same features as Vimeo mobile, except for some of the commands. But it can run on devices, and it actually doesn't require you to modify your application under test, which is very cool, because you can just build your application, test it, and deploy directly to the App Store without any modification. But you have to pay a price for it. You have to buy Visual Studio Premium license, so it's not very scalable if you have a lot of nodes to run your tests in parallel and stuff like that. So we actually decided to stick with Vimeo Mobile. And here's the architecture. So in this case, we don't have any test server inside your application because we use this coded UI, which runs out of the process side by side with your application. And also we have a Windows desktop automation, of course, because we had a lot of internal enterprise Windows clients and we needed automation for these clients. And we wrote a Vinium desktop. It's also completely open source. You can find it on GitHub. So it's kind of like WinApp driver from Microsoft, but it also exists for maybe 2 years or even more. And it basically can automate almost any Windows desktop application which is accessible by Microsoft Accessibility. So if a screen reader can read UI in elements in UI in your application, then you should be able to automate it. It does not require you to modify your application in tests, just like coded UI. But unlike coded UI, you don't have to buy Visual Studio license, so you don't even need a Visual Studio installed on your desktop. And it also has a full access to desktop, so you can even automate multiple applications at once, if you have like a cross-app scenario or something like that. And the architecture is just the same as for any Selenium project. And I also have a demo, so if we can switch. Okay, so we'll automate the CalcXA, which is basically just a standard calculator from the Windows without any modifications, stuff like that. So it's just calculates 2^8 and validates the result. So you can basically automate, you can use it not only for testing, but also for automation of some scenarios where you have tools which have no API, so they have only UI stuff. Okay. So can we get slides back? Here's slides. So here's an example of our code sample which we used to record this demo. It's written in C sharp, and actually I had a previous slide, but I can switch to it. And and here's the same code, which is written in Python, so it's also one of the benefits using Selenium-based approach, because we have a lot of different teams in our company, and each team prefers their own language to write the automation, so one team can use Python, another team can use C-sharp, for example, and there is almost no difference. And actually, that's all I have. But we also have more automation tools. We have VMMaster, which is basically like a Selenium grid on steroids. So this is basically browser's cloud. When you run your Selenium test and you request a new session, it gives you a new virtual machine with a clean state. So you don't get a flakiness because of dirty environment in which you run your tests. And also we have a stateful tools, which you can use combined with Appium and OpenSmart test farm, which is also open source tool, to build an Android cloud automation with video recording and stuff like that. So now it's all. Thank you. Do you have any?
Very good. Thank you, Nikolai. So I think we have a little bit of time for questions. We are, after this, going to break for lunch, so prepare yourselves. First question, though, which languages do you support in Winium?
So, actually, because it's Selenium-based, you can use any language to write your test. So your test is basically just an HTTP client. So if you have a language which can send HTTP requests, you basically all set up. You can use Python, you can use C sharp, you can use Java. So basically any language, actually.
Very good. Any questions in the room? All right, so I'll ask this one and get the microphone to you. But can Winium handle responsiveness?
I'm not sure how to answer this question, because it depends on what you mean under responsiveness. So by itself, Winium is just a like a Selenium-based automation tool, so it does not... you can use it actually to check if your interface behaves correctly on different sizes, screen sizes, by actually getting elements width and stuff like that and asserting against it. But it's quite like an unusual scenario, I think, to use. So usually to do stuff like that, you use something like Apply Tools or another responsive UI verification tool.
My question is in the footer of a couple of your slides, you made reference to a tool called UI Spy. Can you explain what that is?
Yeah, so it's basically it's one of the tools which came with Windows SDK. And this tool is usually used to verify that your application is accessible. So you can use this tool to see which elements there are in your application and which labels they have. So when the screen reader will read the screen, it will read it correctly, basically. So it's like a UI verification tool of some kind.
Okay, and maybe one more. Can Winium run the automation on multiple phones connected to a computer?
Well, actually, only Coded UI can run on devices without limitation. But it turns out that you can only connect one device at a time under one user. So it's just a limitation of API provided by Microsoft. But I think if you manage to run multiple users on single desktop, then you can like assign each USB to a single user, and then it should be possible to run multiple tests on multiple devices from a single machine.
Okay. So to stay on track, let's give another hand to Nikolai.